Let's go to Luke chapter 1. There you go. In the Message version. I have it printed out just so that everybody can read along with me. And this is the word that the Lord gave me. It says here in Luke chapter 1, starting with verse 5 in the Message version, it says a childless couple conceives. Let's just think about right now where you've been barren and where you need conception to take place. All right. So during the rule of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest assigned service in the regiment Abijah. His name was Zechariah. His wife was a descendant from the daughters of Aaron. Her name was Elizabeth. Together they lived honorably before God, careful in keeping to the ways of the commandment and enjoying a clear conscience before God. But they were childless. They were barren because Elizabeth could not conceive, and now they were old. Just get a picture of that. Seems like impossible, huh? It so happened that as Zechariah was carrying out his priestly duties before God, working the shift assigned to his regiment, it came his one turn in life to enter the sanctuary of God and burn incense. The congregation was gathered and praying outside the temple at the hour of the incense offering. Unannounced, an angel appeared just to the right of the altar of incense, and Zechariah was paralyzed in fear. And the angel reassured him, "Don't fear, Zechariah." He said, "Don't fear, Zechariah. Your prayer has been heard. Elizabeth, your wife, will bear a son by you, and you are to name him John. And you're going to leap like a gazelle for joy. And not only you, many will delight in his birth, and he'll achieve great stature with God. He'll drink neither wine nor beer. He'll be filled with the Holy Spirit from the moment he leaves his mother's womb. He will turn many sons and daughters of Israel back to their God. He will herald God's arrival in the style and strength of Elijah, soften the hearts of parents to children, and kindle devout understanding among hardened skeptics. He'll get the people ready for God." Zechariah said to the angel, "Do you expect me to believe this?" See, now he needs a smack. "I'm an old man and my wife is an old woman." But the angel said, "I am Gabriel and I'm going to smack you." He said, "The centennial of God sent especially to bring you this glad news. But because you won't believe me, you'll be unable to say a word until the day of your son's birth. Every word I have spoken to you will come true on God's time, God's time, on time, God's time." Meanwhile, the congregation waiting for Zechariah was getting restless, wondering what in the world's happening here. And when he came out, couldn't speak, they knew he had seen a vision. And he continued speechless and had to use sign language with the people. And when the course of his priestly assignment was completed, he went back home. And it wasn't long before his wife, Elizabeth, conceived. And she went off by herself for 5 months, relishing her pregnancy. So this is how God acts to remedy my unfortunate condition, she said. So I'm going to end it there, but let's just go back to this. And here's the word that I felt like the Lord gave me because of this birthing process. And a time we're in a victorious time, but because of delays and because of postponements and denials of things, we could respond very much like Zechariah. Amen. Everybody understand? There's a scripture in Ezekiel 12 that I want to read to you. 25, and it's not on there. It says, "For I, the Lord, I will speak, and the word that I speak shall be performed, come to pass. It shall be no more delayed or prolonged for in your days." And then he says, "Oh, rebellious house, I will speak the word and I will perform it, says the Lord." And he's saying that there will be absolutely no more delays. And he says, "And the prophecies that seem to be afar off will come to pass." So here, when I was reading this, the Lord spoke to me and he said, "Listen," he said, "check your heart out." He spoke to me first. He said, "Check your heart out and see where there's any areas of your heart where because of postponement, because of delays, because of just circumstances that have gone down in your life, that you might be on lockdown, where you might be in that place like Zechariah," right? Because that could be any one of us responding that way, like, "Now? How long have I been praying for this?" But I felt like the Lord said that there was a reset button that he's pushing to reset us back to that place of alignment with the Spirit of the Lord, that he is resetting us. We're shifting back into that place of Lord, I believe. I'm not going to try to figure you out because I want that time of visitation. There are the angels of the Lord. We heard, you know, and we know that in Hebrews it says that the angels of the Lord are ministering servants for us. We don't command them, but the angels in Daniel chapter 9 or 10 says that they come, they hearken because of your words. Now, what happened here, we saw that Gabriel said to Zechariah, because of your unbelief, you're not going to be able to speak for 9 months. Because he didn't want to messing with what God had for this child to be born. Because we undo things with our words. I'm never going to get ahead. I'm never going to do this. I'm never going to do that. When is this going to happen? I hate the weather. I hate the, you know, like we all do it. But we have to really see, like, okay, Lord, what is it in my life that I could be hindering you? And so a lot of times we you know, we're blaming God or we're aggravated and we're saying we're doing everything we can. But I venture to say maybe we're not. Maybe it's the words we're saying. But that's not even my point. You know, the enemy desires to create his reality to become real in our lives. His reality is postponement, delay, not having breakthrough. That's his reality. God's reality is I'm the God of the impossible. I'm the God of breakthrough. I'm the God who can make things where and open up a door where there is no door. Right? God wants that. There's portals. And someone said to me, well, that's not in the Bible. Well, if you look up the word door in the Bible, it means portal. Where in Revelation, it says in Revelations 4, where it says, come up here. So that I can show you things to come. There's an open door he wants us to go through. Well, that word door means a portal. It's an entranceway. It's an opening. So during worship, what I saw, I was meditating on that scripture in Ezekiel 12 about an opening. And what the Lord was saying, so many of us are at this place where it seems like, you know, Peter was singing, his strongholds are coming down. It seems like, oh, Lord, how long? How long am I going to keep going through this? How long am I going to wait for my healing? And you know, like those little cardboard blocks, kids, bills, and that's what I saw. And I saw it's just going, he says, all you have to do is just push it. Just keep pressing. The whole thing was tumbling down. That's where we're at. And so God's saying, don't back up now. Press forward now. It's you know, what could be holding us back? And I'll get into that in a minute. So one of the things is obviously unbelief. You know, unbelief will hinder us. It'll keep us in that place of lockdown. And so the other thing is, like what I was thinking of is passivity. And I looked up the word passivity, and it means, listen to this. This is what Zechariah did. Acceptance of what happens without active response or resistance. A state of inactivity. Where are you at? I mean, I had, you know, listen, I'm preaching to you, but I had to check over my heart. Where am I at? Where am I in that place of inactivity? I'm here because I believe, first of all, you know, I love the Lord because I wouldn't be here. I wouldn't waste my time if I didn't think this was for real. And he wants the best for us. And am I passive in any area of my life because I haven't seen what I wanted to see? I mean, am I the only one who ever thinks that way? Right? And so when the Lord spoke to me about this, he said, I want to redeem that which has been lost and stolen. And I want to bring that restoration. And things that have been stolen, that have been locked up for our inheritance or our goals or our desires, that's not lost. There's redemption that comes. You know, in Luke chapter 16, the woman was crying out and she was saying, give me justice for my adversary. Give me, she didn't let up. The Bible says in the King James that the judge was black and blue from her bugging him and that she didn't let up. Well, that's us. And he said, how much more will I not, you know, like respond to you? But a lot of times he has to shift our hearts. A lot of times there has to be discipline. We saw that in 5779. We saw that with, what's his name, Robert Heinlein, what he was saying. There's timings, there's seasons. In Ecclesiastes 3, to everything there's a season. Right? There's a timing, just like Christmas time. We're not going to, you know, wear Christmas, you know, outfits now in the summer, right? There's a timing. There's a season for things. We all get that in the natural, but we have to understand here in the spiritual aspect that God wants us to break the limitations off. He doesn't want us to settle for where we're at. He doesn't want us to be in this inactive state, to just accept what's happening.